No? What was it? Maybe in the hurry, maybe you must be hurry to get over here in the Audi. Did you? Okay. So, I would like to ask you a question. Like, what was in the breakfast? Is there any dessert or something in the sweet? No? Poha. Okay, so let it be. So, coming to the topic, before I start my presentation, I would like to. Okay. So, good morning to one and all present over here. Today's I would take this opportunity to welcome you all for the day 4 presentation. My name is Vaibhav Pado.
My name is Shantanu Bhati.
And we are from River Saraswati. Next slide, please. Okay, before the video goes on, I would like to ask you a question. Do you like desserts?
Yes.
Is everyone like desserts?
Yes.
Just raise your hand. Okay, the people over there don't like dessert, I think. Maybe a diabetic person or something. Yes. Okay. So we'll just see the video clip. Maybe there's no audio clip, but it's nothing like there's a. Okay, so by now we have understood what is the topic or what is the induction presentation topic. It's next slide.
So wait, just a second. So first of all, let me ask you, how many of you like donuts? Now put it on hands. Now how many of you have been to Dunkin Donuts? Okay, nice. So I'd like to ask a question again. In how many of you people from where that there's a Dunkin Donuts store in your city? No one knows about it. Keep your raise your hands high, please. In how many of your people that where are you from? You have a Dunkin Donuts store in your city.
Okay, Shantanu, let's cut it as we are less
so
of the time.
Our topic for today is what went wrong with Dunkin Donuts in India. So let's start with it.
What, please?
These are the contents. Next slide, please. Thank you. So this is the introduction part. People in India think that Dunkin Donuts, before the Dunkin Donuts introduced into India, people used to think that donut is just a Hollywood dessert part, and we have seen in most of the movies and most of the advertisings. But later on, the Mad Over Donut introduced their first store in 2008. In Noida, later, and people tested it and they were like, okay, it's just like a sweet vada or something. And some of them tried in the various other neighborhood bakeries, which was just like a donut but not as compared to donut, and the authentic taste was missing over there. So Dunkin Donuts saw this as an opportunity and they tried to grab the Indian market, and they launched their first store in Noida in 2012 April. So from there, I would like to tell you about Dunkin Donuts. It is a Dunkin Donuts is a brand of Dunkin Brands, which is a US based company started by William Rosenberg in 1948. And there are around more than 12,000 restaurants all over the world, and around 3,000 restaurants internationally in 36 countries. Next slide, please.
Now let's hear something about Jubilant Foodworks, which brought Dunkin Donuts to India. So Jubilant Foodworks has a parent company which is known as Jubilant Bharti Group. It's the largest food service company in India. It's based, Jubilant Foodworks is based in Noida, Uttar Pradesh, and it brought the master franchise of Domino's Pizza and Dunkin Donuts.
Dunkin Donuts, like if you know, the donut is a flour dough which is dipped into the deep fried and added with the flavorings and toppings over it, and along with that chocolate and maple glazing. So this is the revenue generated in 2017 and 2018. As you can see that in fiscal year 17 there was around 6,608 crore revenue generated through operations, and order income was around 3.24 crores, and in fiscal year 2018 it is around 678 crores, and order income is 3%. As a percentage growth for the revenue generated for the fiscal year 17 is 11.4, and the total is 11.4, and and this is the revenue breakup, which is according to the stores, around 8% is taken by the donuts and 65% is taken by the beverages of the Dunkin Donuts company, and the rest others are the through other sources. Next slide, please.
Now let's see what actually went wrong with Dunkin Donuts. So I'd like to ask you a question. As a breakfast segment, how many people of you would like to eat a donut as a breakfast thrice or four times a week? Please raise your hands.
Over there.
Okay, that will be my friend actually. So that's what went wrong with Dunkin Donuts. They actually targeted the breakfast segment in India. As soon as they came, they targeted the breakfast segment. And India, as we know, as an Indian culture, we probably won't go out in the morning for a donut and a coffee. That too, thrice or four times a week. So that's what went wrong. The second was the dine-in culture and the takeaway culture problem. In India, we prefer more a dine-in culture than a takeaway culture. Back in 2016, when Dunkin Donuts started expanding its store in all over the India, it was too soon. They actually expanded to 77 stores in just 3 years without a market research. The next is consumer perceived. When Dunkin Donuts came to India, the consumers, everyone perceived it as a dessert rather than a breakfast meal. That what went wrong with the Dunkin Donuts. Next slide.
So there are a few more points what were the reasons due to their falling in the losses. They had poor brand positioning. There was a preliminary market research. They failed in preliminary market research. Also, they failed in to sense the preferences of Indian customers, which was like Indian customers. They prefer pizzas and burgers, right? Over the donuts. And that made losses to them. Second one is lack of viable market offering by Dunkin Donuts. So as we have seen that 65% of the revenues generated by the Dunkin Donuts is through beverages, and there was lack of offerings through them. If you could see the Starbucks, they have changed according to the Indian market. They have changed their taste and coffees according to the Indian market. Next slide, please.
So we'll now look at the market strategy that they used to recover from the falling sales. The first of all, they brought the Indian beverages like iced tea and lychee coolattas.
Second one is they introduced the kaju katli and moti chur to raise their profits, but it didn't work most of the time. And second one, they introduced burgers. Shaken iced teas were the next introduction into the market. These are the network restaurants, network in all over the country in India. Right now there are around 32 restaurants all over the country in cities like Chandigarh, Delhi, Chennai, etc. Next slide.
So we'll look at the future plan now. We know that in 2016 they have 77 stores, and by June 2018 they had